I had the option of becoming a business coach without even running my own business successfully. I had the option of writing a book on my own business without even me cracking all the elements of running a successful business. There was a coaching program that I had signed up for. And in that coaching program, everybody was turning coaches and consultants. Whether they had the skill or not was irrelevant. People who had no idea about running a business also were becoming business coaches. I was advised to do the same. But then I thought it just somehow didn't gel well with me. Something was missing, you know. And that time I hadn't figured out the marketing. Selling was already my forte, but marketing I had not figured out for my business. You know, having a non-stop stream of projects lined up, you know, people waiting in line to work with you, people's project lined up. I'd not figured that out that time. How could I become a business coach? Internally, my soul rejected this idea. I could not come to terms with it. And it gave me a lot of heartache, a lot of depression, a lot of, you know, frustration that there are other people who are doing it and they're making a lot of money. And here I am, you know, I can do the same thing, but I'm just not able to do it. I just cannot get myself to terms with teaching people something that I had not completely cracked myself, you know. And that just was very, very unfair to me and unfair to anybody who would learn from me. So I went back to the drawing board and I said, you know what, whatever they're teaching me, I don't want to learn it. I want to do it my own way. My core values are authenticity. My core values are contribution. And these two things, if I don't take them with me, I'm never going to be successful, no matter what I do. So I took 1.5 years to really stabilize my business, to really crack the formula for my own business. And it's not a replica of anybody else's business. I just, you know, took that time to get it right first. And I invested time, you know, I did project after project. I stayed up all nights. You know, I communicated with people. I talked to people, you know, there were so many complex things that I learned to do myself. And I got to a place where even the uncomfortable started to seem comfortable. I got better and better at whatever I was doing. And I have documented everything in my book right now, which will soon be available. The point I'm trying to make is that there is a thing about coaches and consultants, you know, coaches especially, trainers and coaches. Everybody wants to be a trainer and coach. Whether they have experience and expertise in a particular domain is irrelevant. Just because the herd is becoming a trainer and a coach and a mentor, everybody's trying to become trainer, coach, and a mentor. But because my values are very strong, because I'm a rebel, and because I don't, you know, settle with whatever somebody tells me, I want to experiment it myself. I've just carved a whole different way for myself, which nobody taught me. Yes, there are some tools, there are some strategies I learned from many different places, including them, you know, wherever credit is due, I will give it to them. But the complete idea of, you know, starting a coaching business without really getting it right yourself was not being honest, not to myself and not to people who I would be coaching. But today when I say that, you know what, I'm Madam Gigster, you know, I help people start a business from scratch and I know the formula for them to become successful, whether it's as freelancers, as entrepreneurs, you know, small businesses, you know, I can do that. I have confidence in my own framework. I have confidence in my own journey. And I'm a little ahead of all these people who are following me, who are learning from me, you know. And I feel that I am glad that I waited and I got it right first myself. And now I feel like, you know what, this is good. This is how it should have been, you know. So sometimes we get influenced by people. We get influenced by their Rolex watches. We get influenced by their suits. We get influenced by their cars. and their lifestyle, you know. But instead of following other people's journey, I think what people should teach us is to be authentic to ourselves and just discover our own journey, which should not be and must not be a replica of their journey. It should just be our own journey. And it could be a small journey. It could be, you know, small victories. And we should celebrate those victories. But if we don't get the results that they are getting, then we get disappointed. Because you know, it's that whole aura is very exciting. You know, we all want to live that perfect life, but that's not perfect. Nobody's perfect. You know, that's just an image, you know, and that's just a positioning. That's just a created brand, you know, and if you are vulnerable, if you are not satisfied with yourself, if you don't love yourself, you fall for it, you know, and then you have to pay for it. More than money, the time that has gone by does not come back, you know, especially if you're in your 40s. You know, time is very, very valuable. So, you know, be careful of who you choose your path with, and make sure that you're authentic with yourself. You're completely honest with yourself.